Welcome back to Trailer Park Cookin. I'm Genie B. Delishus. I am so glad that my fans are watching me right now, and thank you for being so supportive of me. Even the bad comments are welcome. I love the good comments the most. Anyway, as you notice, I'm in a different kitchen. I'm over at a friend's house because the show must go on. We gotta keep Genie B going. And who wouldn't want to keep Genie B going? I don't know very many people who wouldn't, because we love our show. Anyway, today I'm going to be making wonton surprise. You can do anything with wonton wrappers or egg roll wrappers, but we picked up some wonton wrappers at the dollar store. And I'm just going to cook up a concoction of onions, hamburgers that are frozen panties, and put a little bit of cheese in it because I love my cheese. And then I'm going to deep fry them in some oil in a small pan. So let's get started. The first thing we're going to do is cut up the onion. I'm going to cut the onion up into small pieces. So cut them lengthways and then cut them small ways. I love hamburger patties because not only can you just make barbecued hamburgers from a frozen state, but you can use them to make spaghetti or meatloaf or anything like that. So we've got a couple patties here. So it's just me and my cameraman. This is who's going to be eating it. We'll just stick the patties in the pan. Turn it on to about number 7 on the stove, which I guess would be like medium high, medium low. And then let them start cooking. I've got a couple different seasonings here, some soul food seasoning and some cumin. Cumin's kind of like a taco flavored seasoning. And who doesn't like a little bit of soul food? Sprinkle that on my hamburger. So why the hamburgers cooking? Why am I at my friend's house? Well, Genie B had to move again. So now I'm roommating with people, and today my roommate was busy in her kitchen, so I didn't want to share the space with her, so I decided to go to my friend's house. It just so happened to be my producer's house. He's got a tiny little kitchen. So there's not much room to work in, but we're going to do our best. Let me think of some of the comments that people have made on my videos. Have to think about it. You want more videos? Yay! I always love that comment. Where's the videos, Genie? Well, I'm here for you. So the hamburgers are starting to cook, so I'm gonna cut them up with my spatula. Without making a mess, hopefully. So you see all the oil that's in there. I don't really want that in the wonton, so I'm just gonna stick it in a strainer. Turn off the burner. Run some hot water over it. Not that much grease, but, and then we'll put some more cumin and stuff on it. Turning off that burner because I'm going to get this other pan started to heat up some oil. While the oil's heating, we'll get our wonton wrappers together. I'm putting about 2 cups of oil in this little small pan. I'm going to turn it on to, definitely don't want it on high, but I'm going to say about a number 7 again. So we have our wonton wrappers. And in this container here, we have starch. You can use flour too, and a little bit of water. This is what's gonna help us seal the wonton wrappers. It's about the consistency of, I don't know, milk. You just need a little bit. So I have a little fork here, and on each little square, we're gonna cover the edge on each side. With a little bit of this starch water to make a sill. And right in the center, we're just gonna scoop a little bit of the meat. It's a little hot. That's probably a little too much for these things. And we've got the cheese here. Just a little tiny pinch of cheese. We'll see how this one goes and then we'll make our ingredients accordingly. It's kind of falling in a little bit. And then just press the edges like that down. So you have a nice little triangle when you're done. So that's the before wonton. Okay, so now the oil is hot and we've got a few of these cooked or ready to go, we can just stick them in the oil a couple at a time. It's not going to take very long to cook them on both sides. Literally just a couple seconds, so they're golden brown on each side. Otherwise they're going to burn. This is a great little another hors d'oeuvre for parties or whatever. You could put fruit fillings or any kind of anything inside of a wonton wrapper or an egg roll wrapper. And I got some Polish-style mustard here that I'm going to dip these in. It smells really good. They're cool enough to try now. I'm just going to dip it in that mustard sauce. Not too shabby. The outside's crispy, and then there's some melted gooey cheese on the inside with the hamburger and onion, and who doesn't really like hamburger and onions? It's another fun recipe for your kids, for your family, for get-togethers or dinners. Like I always say, join me next time for another great recipe on Trailer Park Cookin'. I'm Genie B. Delishus. Bye, y'all!